On the controversial edge tonight, stem cell research. It's a procedure polarizing America and the White House. Advocates like paralyzed actor Christopher Reeves, who I interviewed last summer, say fetal stem cells may give many Americans their lives back, not destroy lives, as opponents claim.
They can become any tissue in the human body. And they're the body's self-repair kit, and they can, you know, become a new heart, a new liver, cure diabetes, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, stroke, spinal cord injury, so I'm not just preaching for myself, but really for all Americans.
But some Americans say experimenting with stem cells amounts to murder. Joining us now from Washington to debate stem cell research, Dan Perry of the Alliance for Aging Research. They argue that nothing can be more pro-life than stem cell research. But Cathy Brown of American Life Week has launched a national campaign to urge President Bush to issue an executive order banning embryonic stem cell research. They both join me from Washington. Welcome. All right, I just wanted to make it clear that today, of course, was the deadline for scientists to apply to the National Institutes of Health for funding to do research on stem cells. Dan, ultimately, what do you think the president will decide? Will he allow this to go through?
I do think he will, and I certainly think it's in the best interest of the country and of patients that face devastating diseases such as cancer, Parkinson's, and diabetes. I believe over the next 6 months you will see rigorous scientific review of the applications that have come in, holding the applications both to a high level of scientific science and as well making sure that they meet the guidelines that have been put in place to make sure that we are meeting high ethical standards as well as good science and potentially great benefit for patients.
Cathy, I know you are adamantly opposed to this, but would you acknowledge tonight that there is scientific promise if this experimentation is allowed to be done?
Thank you, Paula. I think that the cutting edge research is with adult stem cells, not stem cells obtained from embryonic human persons. If you've been following the news lately, the New England Journal of Medicine has come out with an article which clearly states that stem cells obtained from fetal cells have deleterious effects to those patients, those Parkinson's patients which have used them. The same journal also has evidence. We have evidence to prove that cutting-edge research is using adult stem cells, not research which involves the experimentation, the death of a human person in his embryonic stage of development.
Dan, do you want to weigh in on that? For those of us who aren't well versed in the specifics of this medical information, the use of fetal stem cells versus adult stem cells.
I do indeed.
In fact, why wouldn't you use adult stem cells?
Well, scientists don't know for sure how adult stem cells are going to be able to...
No, scientists know exactly how adult stem cells work. They do not know how embryonic stem cells work, though. There's no empirical evidence to suggest that this research involving the destruction of a human person in his embryonic stage of development will have a positive effect on Parkinson's patients. But we do know that it involves the murder of the human person in his embryonic stage of development.
All right, let's give Dan a chance to respond to that.
Thank you, Paula. There is indeed evidence to suggest that some of the so-called adult stem cells may have clinical application. We know that from animal research that there is tremendous potential of the embryonic cells. And in fact, most scientists think that that has greater potential. From the point of view of patients and their families, why shouldn't we fund all forms of this research? How could we possibly tell a young girl with juvenile diabetes to wait 10 years only to find out that adult stem cells won't do the trick and then go back and begin to do the embryonic work? And I suspect that the American Life League and other groups will never allow us to pursue the potential of the embryonic stem cell research.
Even though these are
far from being human beings, these are undifferentiated clusters of cells.
I'm going to cut both of you off because I want you to respond to something Michael J. Fox said on our network not long ago. As both of you know, he is outspoken in his support of fetal stem cell research. Let's listen to what he had to say about this.
A lot of this material is going to be thrown away. This is not harvesting. This is nothing other than the use of materials that would be wasted in order to benefit people. And I think that the science is going to happen. And I think that the government should be on board and federally fund research with those materials.
All right, Cathy, what about the point Michael J. Fox is making? And I think we need to explain to our audience, he's referring to folks who have in vitro procedures done on them. They will leave anywhere from, well, you can't say how many embryos because it varies from procedure to procedure, but they will leave embryos frozen. And at a point where they decide that they don't need them anymore, those are simply thawed, and that's the end of them. So why not use those unclaimed embryos for this kind of research? They're going to be thrown away anyway in some cases.
Well, 2 points. One, there's no evidence to suggest that these human persons are going to be discarded. As a matter of fact, there's a lawsuit that has been filed by a Christian adoption agency against Tommy Thompson, you know, because they would like to see these human persons be returned to their parents and possibly adopted out. And regardless of that fact, murder is not justifiable. We're talking about...
So you're saying basically it's murder both ways. It's murder if you allow these embryos, if you're not going to use them to unthaw and be discarded or be used in research. I need a quick answer so Dan can get the final word here.
We have a responsibility to find an ethical solution. Tossing them out is not an option. Experimenting on human persons is not an option either.
But Dan, the bottom line is they are getting tossed out, aren't they? And you got about 15 seconds for a final thought tonight.
Absolutely. They will be destroyed. They will be discarded. Why shouldn't a couple that has sought in vitro fertilization have produced this material in a laboratory allow that to be donated to medical research if they're not going to use it to achieve
a
pregnancy?
All right.
Human person.
We're going to have to leave the debate there this evening. Cathy Brown, Dan Perry, thank you for both of your perspectives. Thank you all for watching at home. See you tomorrow night.